What's up, YouTube? This is Ben from Curse Paranormal.
It's James again.
We're up here at Cullman Colonel's house. We're going to be learning a little bit of history about the town that I'm from and stuff like that. I'm real curious. This used to be a wild town back in the day when it was wet. And it's wet again. They sell beer and stuff, but back in the 30s, it was real wild. KKK was like real big around here.
Yeah, the KKK was running Cullman.
But check some of the stuff out though. Check that out. It's pretty cool, ain't it? I wonder if that was hand built. Looks like it was. Real nice work. Look at that. It's pretty, ain't it?
Yeah, it's not all even. It might
have been hand built. Woodcraft from Germany.
Yeah, it's
hand built.
Yeah.
There you go. Nice. Bring it back out. There you go. That's pretty. There's Colonel Cullman himself.
That was not planned at all.
Right.
It was erected in 1930. City of Cullman Sentinel Time Capsule, 1873 to 1973.
This is all about Colonel Cullman. Y'all can sit and read it. I ain't gonna read it none out.
We'll do that some other time. We'll come up here. This part was erected in 1912. Judge of probate.
Well, yeah. There's Cullman Colonel himself. Let's go in and see what we can't find out about Cullman. This is his house. Pretty old house. That's Cullman City Hall over there.
This here is Colonel Cullman's house.
Oh, they only open up to 2 o'clock today.
Till 2. Huh?
Till 2.
They don't open
till 2. No, they close at 2.
Hello.
Howdy, howdy.
How are you
today? All pretty good. How about you?
All pretty good. Pretty nice every day.
Yes, making a YouTube. I'm okay. From Cullman.
Okay.
You wouldn't happen to be the historian.
I could probably answer questions if you had it.
Okay. I was wondering about, like, you care if I get you on camera or anything?
Well, not today.
Okay. how Cullman was back in them days, like the history of Cullman and everything.
Well, John Cullman was from Germany.
Right.
And he came here in the 1870s and founded the town.
Okay. Are y'all together?
Yeah. Okay.
All right. And I need to get you some change. Let me get that.
All right.
There's a picture of him.
Bankhead National. Forest, Moulton, Town Creek, Portland. That's where I'm from. Well, not really from. I thought I grew up most of my life.
That's okay. That's
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. But John Cullman was from Germany. He came here in the 1870s. The train had just come through the area, and there weren't many settlers here, so he came, and his idea was to found a German colony.
Right.
So he strictly recruited Germans.
Okay.
And he lived till 1895, about 27 years. And during that time, all the people he tried to get were Germans. Mm-hmm. So the early years was mostly German-speaking people.
Oh, okay. That's
so, it starts right here. This building on the outside is a copy of his house.
Okay.
And the original house was on the street behind us. When you cross over 278 to down the left, there's a coffee shop, Berkeley Bob's.
Yeah.
And that's where the house was. And
okay.
It burned in 1912, and then we had our centennial. We raised money to build a museum. We decided to make the outside look like his house.
Oh, okay. Okay. That's,
well, that's, I thought this was his actual house.
It looked like it, but it's not. We had, when you get around, kind of go around in a big circle, when you get around the district, there's a picture of
the actual house.
So, like, the old 31, that was like the main strip through Cullman, right?
Well, when John Cullman came here, that was before, you know, cars and everything.
Yeah, right.
And
yeah.
So the main way in and out of Cullman was the train.
Oh, okay.
That's where it's at now. So, yeah. First Avenue East and First Avenue West were downtown Cullman.
Okay.
Those came off the train.
Yeah.
And then, of course, 31 now with cars.
Okay. I remember I grew up here.
Yeah.
This is my hometown.
Yeah.
And my papa always told me that it was kind of a rough town back, you know, in his days, because it was wet and all that.
When John Cullman was alive, it was a German town, and it was wet, and they made beer and wine, and well, not too many problems. And then when Prohibition came, they closed all that up. Of course, there's a lot of secret, or not, you know, wasn't too big a secret. And then, after Prohibition, that was what your grandfather's home. When they went wet again, I don't know what happened. They opened. There was a lot of saloons and stuff. And so, in the 30s, there was a lot of trouble and stuff.
Yeah.
And then the story goes, when the men went to fight World War II, the women and the Baptist preachers got together and voted dry.
Oh, okay.
And we were dry 7 years ago.
Yeah, that's what I was amazed about it, you know, going back wet, because I was like, you know, I always heard him talk about how rough it was.
Yeah, but a lot of, well, and that's probably another reason we got to go wet this last month, because most of those people that remembered it were dead.
Yeah. Do you know much about, like, was there, like, a lot of Indians here when they come through?
It kind of comes down that platform there, but this area was mostly a buffer zone for, like, hunting and keeping that of each other's territory.
Okay.
So there was a few little camps, and it was mostly Cherokee back then.
Okay. Because I do, I got a paranormal channel on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
And I just don't do paranormal. I like looking into the history and stuff like that.
Well, there's a, in Lakeland, there's a, the Cherokee have a place where they have powwows, and they have a museum there too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I have to go down and check that out.
Well, I'm right here. If you have any questions, just holler.
All right, I appreciate it.
I like how they got that right there. That goes straight to the outside.
Yeah. Look at them, all them old tools.
Is that a hammer?
Yeah, looks like one, don't it?
It does, don't it? I like the, they got a sword up there.
Yeah.
That wasn't there last time.
I don't know if that would be the old Confederate.
Yeah, I think that would be Confederate.
I won't say that would be Confederate.
These old rope beds.
Yeah, Confederate was curtained.
Could you imagine having to sleep on one of these old broke beds like this? Could you imagine having to sleep on one of these old rope beds, though? Look at that old fiddle. Talks about the Confederate families, how hard they had it. This is a widow's war. I like to read that. Here's that. Let's get back here a little bit. 20 ages and 2. One Barefoot became a war widow when her husband, Private Joel Barefoot, Company of 37 Alabama Infantry, died in his service. She was left to raise 7 children between the ages of 2 and 12. The Alabama Confederacy. Alabamians who wanted the state of Alabama to secede from the Union were called Confederates. In this area of Alabama, Cullman County, were independent farmers. In 1860, ranked 2nd in the nation in cotton productions. However, this hilly area of Alabama production is less than 400 bales. South Alabama School.
The one in the wall is just for decoration.
It's just for decoration.
Yeah. It's not really a. I mean, it's old, but it's not a special. That one? Yeah.
Yes.
I was wondering if that was ever being either Union or.
Most people
in
the hill.
Yeah, we was kind of curious about it because the last time we walked through, I think that was there. If it was, it didn't catch my eye.
Okay. Yeah, it's been there a long time, but it might not have been when we came through. So, but it's just kind of a decoration.
So, yeah. Is it true about Banger Cave, how it was an old Confederate depot?
Well, I don't know about that. It was a casino.
I heard it was a bar, too. Then it was like right before.
It's 5 for adults, 4 for seniors, and 3 for students.
4 for
students. I heard it was an old casino. Then it was like before then, it was an old Confederate depot where they went.
I've never heard that. I'm not saying it's not, but I knew about the casino part.
Yeah. Was it big gangsters or anything come down there?
That's what I understood.
Okay,
it wasn't up very long and then it kind of mysteriously burned.
Oh, okay.
So it's pretty interesting. This is our main street. There's just a little bit of everything here. I'll be checking on you.
All right. The whole mouth of Alabama. Like I said, I grew up here and everything, and you know, I'm trying to learn like the different parts of, you know, of Cullman, how Cullman was back in the day, because I've heard stories. I want to try to figure out before I say any of the stories, you know, between faction, you know, facts and fiction. You know, I don't want to tell no lies, you know. I want to know the whole truth about things. And bottles. Yeah, we've been out there to the Civil War Museum.
Oh yeah, that's a fun place.
Talked to Mr. Fred.
Yeah, he's a character.
Yeah, he is. He's a good old guy. We went out there one weekend and rented the cabin and
yeah, it was like my
graduation deal.
Confederate money. My head is a movie to
it. And keep Confederate troops away from Union armies advancing on Vicksburg and Chattanooga. Union Colonel Abel D. Straight is chosen to lead a raid across North Alabama to cut the railroad line that connects Atlanta to Chattanooga. Straight has already been in North Alabama and is familiar with his people. Two companies of Union cavalry recruited from the area through which his army will travel guide his four regiments of mounted infantry. His route will take him across Sand Mountain, where empty country and Union sympathizers could aid his march. It is a good plan, until someone decided that his men should be mounted on mules.
There is much fun and danger experienced in this taming, as most mules were mounted with buck, jump stiff leg with heads down and heels up and over the rider would go. Fortunately, no one was fiercely hurt.
Nathan Buford, of course.
Is hot on their trail.
He fought for the Union, and his Nathan Buford Forrest and fought for the Confederate. And at the museum, we're talking about the battlefield. I've made a video, I think, got it edited and got it up, but we made a video out there. So. Old pictures.
And the Air Force tries to and Straight continues on his mission to cut the railroad. Not knowing Straight's intended target, Forrest hastily divides his force and sends cavalrymen to block escape routes toward Decatur and Huntsville. Forrest then leads the vanguard chasing Straight down the old Farm Road and catches the Union rear guard at Crooked Creek.
Cripple Creek.
The stubborn, exhausted, and thirsty humans refuse to give up.
Whenever you see anything blue, shoot at it. Do all you can to keep up the scare.
The Alabamians delay the Confederates crossing the creek, allowing Straight and the tourists capture
the creek. I've done our Cripple Creek.
The hill and take a strong position on the top of the mountain.
That old bell. Cullman. And everything. The governor Guy Hunt, Jim Folsom, Big Jim Folsom.
Hey, Dave. I found Annabelle.
Did you?
Yeah.
Hang on.
There's two
of them
in here.
I'll be in there a minute. Probate judge. Judges. Now, if I ain't mistaken, Big Jim Folsom and his son Jim Folsom, both has got houses here in Cullman. I might be wrong on that, but I think they are. We'll just have to find out. Whoa. Yeah. right there.
Yeah.
Whoa, there she is.
It's two of them.
Yeah, two of them. Annabelle's. Look at her.
I like the train.
Yeah, that old train. Look at
that. Imagine the history that's attached to these.
I know.
If they could tell a story, I would definitely listen.
Yeah.
To it.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Pictures of Cullman County.
And an old doctor's bed.
Not there'd be what you'd see in the therapist's office.
Yeah. That's what I see all the time.
Music box.
Look at that old music box. Oh, keyboard.
Nah.
Yeah, knock a little files.
Sister City.
That's Frank what I'm Willard. Planning on trying to do.
Frank Roller, Germany is Coleman's sister city.
Hmm.
They have a lion.
Old bedroom. Coleman Colonel.
Any questions?
Gonna ask one, I forgot. Oh yeah, Big Jim Fulton's house. Or right down here, ain't they? The
it's
big,
over by East
Dunlap. Okay. The big white house.
We're having our bicentennial thing next weekend on Saturday. We have a big fireworks show and hot chocolate.
Okay.
So
up here.
It's going to be across the street at Depot Park, unless the weather's bad, then it'll be a festival.
Okay. All right. Good one.
And all those first years are pretty. I
grew up mostly in Lawrence County in the small town of Cullman. I'm from here, but I grew up most of my life in Cullman.
Okay.
We're going.
There's another one, cameras, what are those cameras called?
No.
They have a big Christmas light show.
I have an audio clip, it's called, I go to those all the time.
Yeah.
But I go to church and our youth group always goes.
Yeah.
Just walk around.
That's Nate's statue of that Indian girl.
Papa Lulu?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's... Didn't they say, I think they said she jumped off the bridge
because
her dad wouldn't let her marry a man, so she just jumped off the ball.
They post pictures of her different times of the, you know, seasons of the year.
So, I actually went swimming down there.
Okay, well, I hadn't been in years and years, so I wouldn't
really
probably
cool.
know what, where they is.
It's, that old Jim Folsom house, is that like a museum or anything?
No, somebody lives in it.
We appreciate you taking
right,
the time. Thank
you.
You
come back and see us.
All right.
Come further. Bye.
Appreciate it.
So that was cool. He didn't really seem like he wanted to talk too much. And, you know, I mean, that's cool. That's Colonel Cullman's house. I was hoping I'd get a little bit more information. But he just seemed like he didn't really want to talk.
Yeah, we need to find the actual historian of Cullman.
Yeah.
And see if we can't talk to him.
Yeah. Find some historians, people that know. Because like I said, I want to tell the facts. I don't want to have no lies or nothing like that. I'm doing the research, and we appreciate y'all. Don't forget to give us a big thumbs up.
Yep. Like and subscribe. We'll be back next time.
See you next time. Peace.